I'm here with Diana from Physics Girl.
And we're here in Austin, Texas at ArcAttack Studios.
Howdy.
And this is King Beat.
I just took a spin through the car wash to spruce up for our shoot today. Notice how the water beads up and rolls off my sweet frame?
King Beat, I don't think you're waterproof.
I just took a car wash to spin shoot for our to spruce up today.
Don't worry, he does that all the time. I'm sure that we can fix this.
So what is ArcAttack? This is ArcAttack.
ArcAttack makes music using singing Tesla coils. The notes that you hear are coming right out of the air. They're actually made by the electricity. But before we explain how these coils make music, we have to explain what a Tesla coil is. In the late 19th century, Nikola Tesla devised a machine that he claimed would one day transmit electricity around the world without wires, instead using the air and even Earth itself. Ultimately, the Tesla coil failed to revolutionize how we power our lives, but they're still really cool. A Tesla coil is basically a big transformer. When they're not hanging with Shia LaBeouf, a transformer's job is to amplify voltages, and Tesla coils do this using a trick called resonance.
A Tesla coil is a transformer. This one's a little special because it uses a tuned secondary coil. So the top load and the secondary coil form a tuned circuit. So that means that every time we put energy into it at its resonant frequency, the voltage at the top load gets higher and higher until eventually it gets so high that it becomes a lightning bolt.
So putting in energy at the resonant frequency means you're matching the frequency that you're pumping energy in with the frequency that this is oscillating?
Yeah, exactly. And every time you're putting energy into the system, it still is retaining some of the energy from the last cycle. And so that's why it keeps building up. It's because it's storing it.
Imagine you're pushing a kid on a swing set. By pushing at exactly the right moment, even small forces can add up. Keep pushing at the right moment, and you could send the kid flying over the top.
So we don't usually think of the air as a conductor, but this is making just so much voltage that it makes that happen?
Yeah, the atmosphere will actually break down and become a conductor. When you see the purple spark, you're seeing the nitrogen in the air ionize. And so that means that we're just trading electrons between atoms.
Okay, so that's how a Tesla coil works, but how do you make music with one?
So we've all listened to a speaker where the membrane of the speaker is vibrating air at a specific frequency. So that's actually pushing the molecules of air back and forth. That reaches our ear, and we hear that frequency. With a Tesla coil, as you're ionizing the air, it's getting really, really hot, and the air is expanding, so you're getting these shock waves at the right frequency to make a note.
So let's say you wanted to make like an A note, 440 hertz. We're actually making 440 pops per second.
Exactly.
So how do you get lightning to strike 440 times per second? Well, use a computer controller. We're here with John from ArcAttack. John, how do you turn music into lightning?
So as a composer of ArcAttack, I write the music and then I convert it into a format called MIDI. And MIDI is essentially a musical programming language. And once I get the MIDI file all composed, I put it onto one of these guys, a little SD card, and we plug it into this box down here. This box takes the MIDI and transmits it to the Tesla coils over a fiber optics cable like this guy right here. Now once it gets to the Tesla coil, it interprets that MIDI data and tells it to play certain notes. Say we want to play the note A, which is 440 hertz. We turn the spark on and off 440 times a second.
The end result is just about the most electrifyingly entertaining thing I've ever seen. But you know what they say, you never really understand an instrument until you play it.
The idea of this suit is that I am becoming a human Faraday cage.
Faraday cages are pretty complicated, but an easy way to put it is it keeps the voltage potential of your body all the same, right? So if your head is at a million volts and your feet are also at a million volts, then your whole body has 0 volts of potential, and you need voltage potential in order to be electrocuted.
I'm ready.
In the Faraday suit, any exposed skin could leave me burned or electrocuted. I'm also wearing a hat so my hair doesn't catch on fire. I wanted to shoot lightning from my fingers, but with hundreds of thousands of volts hitting my hand, a fist was a much safer shape.
So singing Tesla coils aren't the only thing that ArcAttack does. Why don't you follow me over to Diana's channel?
We've got another video about how electromagnets can be used to blow up cans.
Goggle up. Whoa! And if you want to know what it was like to be inside those Tesla coils, we shot a 360 video and it is pretty awesome. Links to all that down in the description. And
stay curious. Brought to you by Chet Hesterson's Robot Chassis Wax. Keep that chassis looking classy with Chet Hesterson's Robot Chassis Wax.
What are you talking?
It's for the sponsors. I get $50 every time I say that. It was in my contract.
We want to say a big thanks to Darren from Beyond Slow Motion for all the awesome slow-mo footage. Go check out his YouTube channel. It is awesome stuff. We all know how the journey through the digestive system ends, but few give much thought to how it begins. If the mouth is the doorway, saliva is the greeter, one of the most important substances produced by the body, yet one of the most overlooked, and to many, one of the grossest, conjuring up words like what did I say? I can't, M-O-I-S-T.